A very good morning to all the students of 10th standard of JC English High School. So nowadays we are going through the units of sociology, and in the previous video we have done this chapter name is social stratification, and in the previous video till where we have concluded that social inequality and then education and inequality. Okay, now we will go with gender inequality. Gender means, what is the meaning of gender? Gender means a person is a male or female. And what are the inequality in this? In reality, social perspectives are interdependent. One is dependent on other. What is this I am telling you? It means one's thoughts are influenced by other thoughts. One's thought is influenced by others' thoughts. Somebody is thinking and that is good. If I think, I will try to adopt that one. It may happen due to the thought of the family member, relatives, friends or neighbor. Anyway, anybody, if you see something good, you will also try to adopt that one. That is known as perspective interdependent dependency. Hence, motivational issues. Motivation means inspiration. Motivational issues supporting education of a child, boy or girl, has more in the social sphere of the human life. There are places where people thought there is no need of study and all. Okay, my son will go for business when he will be in the 10th standard. Means he is grown up, he will go for business, no need of study. So this type of thoughts, it gives an effect for the gender inequality. Okay, then there is more gender-based inequality in access to school education, food and health facilities. There is more gender-based inequality in access to school education. The education what? Okay, you will go to the government school, you will go to the this one, your some convent school like that. Okay, these are all these inequalities arise only due to the thought, income, everything. Then food and health facilities. According to National Family Health Survey, National Family Health Survey done by government, every year they are doing this. Okay, what they have done in this survey, what it came, women has lesser BMI. BMI means body index, body mass index. Body mass index is nothing but for every person, what is my height? Okay, that should be proportionate to one specific weight also. Weight and height, they should be in a proportion. Okay, suppose a person is 6 feet, this one, you're tall, and he is having only 55 kg weight. It means something there is a wrong. So that is known as body mass index. Okay, what is this body mass index? I told you. Now what this survey told, 60.9% of the children between 6 and 56 months, 1 month equal to 4 months, 1 month, 12 months equal to 1 year, so 1, 2, 3, 4, almost 5 years till from 6 months to 4 months less than 5 years. Okay, 60.9% of the children between 6 and 56 months have severe anemia. Anemia is a disease which happens due to less blood in the body. Okay, 45.2% of the pregnant women suffer from anemia. Pregnant women means the lady who is going to give a birth to a new child. So the survey is telling that 45.2% of the pregnant women suffers from anemia. So as per this record, women and children need more focus and development with regard to food and nutrition. They must have a proper fooding and nutrition so that this type of anemia or other diseases, it should not means attack them. Okay. With regard to food and nutrition security, to overcome the gender-based discrimination. Okay. Discrimination should not be there. So people should take care. Not only people, government also. Government is the main factor. So government is the main, not factor. Government is the main body who takes care of its citizen. Those, and this survey told that the children and the this one, your lady or pregnant lady, they are more affected. Okay, so we should take care of these people. Now coming to the point is social stratification. What is this social stratification? Stratification is based, okay, now the human society has continued the practicing of classifying people as superior, inferior and upper, lower, and assigning different roles and status. In the society you can see the inferior people, the inferior people and the superior people, means whatever they are doing, they have not studied but they are belonging from Ambani, means he is a good person. Okay, like that, this type of mindset we are having. So the human society has continued the practice of classifying people as superior, inferior and upper, lower, and assigning different roles and status. On this basis only they are getting the status. I told you, no, see, suppose some person is not working, he is jobless. Two persons are jobless. One is from your Ambani family and one is from a normal family. Okay, the status of this person who is from normal family, it will be less, but the person who is from a big family, their status we maintain, or our mindset is like that, to maintain that status on this type of things. This method of dividing people, we are dividing the people, this method of dividing people into different strata and then assigning roles and status in the society is called as social stratification. Okay, now we will go for the features. What are the features of social stratification? Oh, it's written here. Social stratification is social in nature. Stratification is based on the social recognition and importance, but not on physical trait. Okay, whatever I have told, one example and you will understand what this is means. Social stratification is social in nature, means a person's status is not fixed on the physical trait like height, strength or beauty. Okay, person is looking very good, good looking person, it doesn't recognize him as a good status in his talent or anything else. Okay, but on his education, income, profession, skill and other social traits. Okay, how much you are long, how beautiful you are, it doesn't give the status to a person. The status of a person, only you will get a status when your education, income, profession, skill and other social traits are in high level. Next is social stratification is universal. Universal means throughout the world it is like same. Whereas wherever human society exists, wherever there is a human society, social stratification exists based on the division of labor, profession, income and other social traits. Okay, wherever you go in the world, okay, there will be a society, and in that society, in each and everywhere throughout the world, you can see the people doing these social stratification, means classification of poor, rich, like that. Okay, inferior, superior. Next is social stratification is ancient. Ancient means long ago it happens. Okay, it is in existence since the birth of human society. When the birth of human society has been came, from that time only the social stratification has come to existence. Social stratification is found in nomadic society. society also as well as the modern civilized society. Previous time also it was there, nowadays also it is there. If you go for 1950s also, that time also rich and poor was there, and take for today's day, they are also rich and poor or inferior or superior people, they are there. Social stratification exists in different ways. Now this is the last point, it exists in different ways. How? It exists in different name in different areas. For example, in ancient Rome, differences were there between plebeians and patricians. They are two castes in Rome. Okay, now I will go for the Indian thing so you will be able to understand it more easily how it is. In India, there were four groups of people. Okay, from nomadic time in India, there was four types of people. What are they? They are Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and Shudras. These are all on the based of Varna theory. We will discuss this Varna theory in the next class because it's there in detail I will discuss. But so social stratification exists in different way. See, in Rome there was plebeians and patricians. They have divided it like that. In India, how we have divided? There are Brahmin people who do the puja and all, okay. Then Kshatriyas who do the political affairs. Then your comes Vaishyas, they will do business. Shudras, they are the laborers. We will discuss this Varna theory in deep in the next video. Go through the notes and read it properly and check the video for 4 to 5 times. It will be very easy for you to understand. Thank you. See you in the next video.